I am flying back to Oklahoma to see my family for Christmas. When I say Christmas, you may be thinking of warm milk and cookies, maybe even matching PJs for the family. But I'm a Latina, and if that's what you're expecting for Christmas, you're in the wrong house. Let me set the picture of a traditional Perez Mexican family Christmas. There's the loud music that'll keep your ears ringing for the next few days, the crazy kids running around causing chaos, the loud aunts belting their passionate Spanish love songs on their karaoke mics, and at least one drunk cousin slurring his words with a red Solo cup in hand. It's a party, but more than a party, it is a glam runway. So if you think you're showing up to the Perez party in Christmas PJs, think again. Tight dresses, blingy jewelry, basically the Mexican Met Gala. So when I walk in there Christmas Day with nails undone, hair barely brushed, and a good book in hand to read, I might as well have changed my last name and walked myself out. Starting in third grade, my love for math and science blossomed. My eyes glowed up when I thought of all the things I could build and create, never for what I was gonna wear or how I was gonna do my hair. Hours I probably should have spent sleeping or studying for tests were spent teaching myself engineering and learning how to program a robot to turn the light switch off and on in my room so I didn't have to get out of bed at night. It bothered me that there were often compliments for looks and beauty in my family, but very rarely for intelligence and ambition. And tonight, as I walk in unglammed to that Christmas party, I feel like an outsider. You know, I kind of wish I dressed up a bit. And if I'm honest, I feel pretty ugly right now. So when my 14-year-old cousin comes up to me telling me all about her new lash tech certification she just got 2 weeks ago, I'm intrigued. And before I know it, I'm laying on the hard flat table for 2 hours getting tiny synthetic hair glued into each and every one of my eyelash strands. It is a long and very uncomfortable process, but beauty is pain, as they say. When my lashes are done getting plumped and glammed, I honestly don't really know how I feel about them, and I'm not sure if they're me. But what I do know is I'm on cloud nine. With the compliments I'm getting from my friends and my family, I feel beautiful, I feel validated, I feel feminine. It's all fun and games until it isn't. A week later, I'm on my way back to Boston, waiting in the Dallas airport for my plane to board. New year, new me, happily living in the blissful feeling of beauty radiating all from my luscious lashes when it hits me. I have to get these off. I, Beatriz Perez, cannot go into work with these eyelashes on. The thing is, I'm an engineer, but I'm not just any engineer. I'm a young 23-year-old engineer. I'm also a Mexican engineer. And I'm also a woman engineer. And thanks to these lashes here today, I am emphasis on woman engineer. I remember my male classmates in third grade dissing the girls that dressed up, calling them bubbleheads and ditzy, and suddenly I wondered and worried whether my coworkers would see me as a ditz. The panic set in as they call boarding group 4. I'm pacing through the jet bridge, frantically Googling how to remove eyelash extensions quickly. The fear of losing all my real eyelashes or even making myself partially blind with the DIY remedies eventually made me stop Googling. The next morning, I'm standing in front of my closet trying to figure out what to even wear to work when I notice the split right down the middle. There's the t-shirts and jeans on the left and the dresses on the right. There's the engineering me, the one who works all day wiring electronics and analyzing circuit board schematics, trying to fit in with my male coworkers, my male mentors, my male bosses, and then There's the afterwork me, the woman who likes to dress up once in a while. Without a second thought, I pull on my familiar jeans and t-shirt, hoping the toned-down wardrobe will maybe draw a little less attention to myself. Defeated, I walk into work. I make sure to keep my head down with a very shy and shameful high as I pass my coworkers. The once upon a time validation, beauty, and femininity that I got from my lashes has struck the exact opposite today. I feel like an outsider. As I am lost in thought, a ping on my phone suddenly reminds me that the all-team meeting will be happening in the conference room soon. So as I walk into that conference room, I sit down next to my 12 coworkers, 10 of which are male, and I wonder if they're looking at me. I can't tell if it's a, oh, did you get a new haircut? Something looks different, look, or if it's judgment. Are they avoiding eye contact? And it is in this moment that I realize that I have already lost so much with these eyelash extensions. The ability to be lost in doing what I love. My mind is so preoccupied with wondering how people are reacting to my eyelashes that I'm less engaged in my meeting. I'm less concentrated on doing the things that I love. I'm not building, I'm not creating, and I'm not investing my mind fully in doing my engineering job, the job that I love and work so hard to get. Interestingly, outside of work, I've been mentoring young girls entering STEM for 8 years now. I teach them about math and science and binary and robotics, and yet I have failed to teach them what it's actually like to be a woman in STEM and how to navigate those little things that build up and up and how they can eventually stop girls from fully immersing themselves in doing what they love. And if I'm honest, it's because I'm still trying to figure it out myself. I don't wanna feel like there needs to be an engineering me and then an after work me. In the end, I didn't try to forcefully take my eyelash extensions out, but it did take me 4 more days to not let them distract me anymore. But just like any science experiment, I see this as progress. And my hope is the future girls in STEM won't even have to bat an eyelash thinking about what they look like, and they can just focus on enjoying the science.